Welcome to level 3 exponents. Let's get started. So if I asked you what 4 to the 1 half power is, your immediate inclination is to view this probably as like a multiplication problem and try to multiply it somehow or add them or something. And you always have to remind yourself, this is not multiplication. I know when I first learned it, I always was tempted to do something with multiplication. Well, something to the 1 half power might not be intuitive to you, but it actually turns out that this means the same thing as the square root of 4. Or another way, what times itself is equal to 4? And we know that the square root of 4 is 2. It could actually be a positive 2 or a negative 2, because we know that either of those numbers, when they're squared, could equal 4. But for the sake of this one, we'll assume it's always the positive square root. So 4 to the 1 half is equal to 2. Similarly, 9 to the 1 half, well, that would be 3. 16 to the 1 half, now, whoops, 16 to the 1 half, my subconscious gave away the answer. 16 to the 1 half power is 4. 25 to the 1 half power is 5. I think that might make sense to you now. So what does it mean when something is to the 1/3 power? Well, if I say 8 to the 1/3 power, you might already catch on. In the 1/2 power, we said something times something is equal to 4. Well, in the 1/3 power, we have to say that something to the 3rd power is equal to 8. And if you've been practicing your exponents, you know that 2 to the 3rd power is equal to 8. So we know that 8 to the 1/3 is equal to 2. Similarly, 27 to the 1/3 is equal to 3. And 64 to the 1/3 is equal to 4. You might notice that I'm picking particular numbers like 8 and 27 and 64. That's because they have clean cube roots. And by the way, when something is to the 1/3 power, that's the same thing as saying the cube root. I just use terminology without explaining it, which is very bad. So I just used 8 and 27 and 64 because when I raise them to the fractional exponents, they actually come out to be clean numbers. You could use a calculator and do something like 5 to the 1/3 power and you'll get some weird decimal. Let's do some more problems. So we know that 9 to the 1/2 is equal to 3. Well, what do you think 9 to the 2/3 is equal to? Well, it turns out that this is equivalent to 9 to the, oh, whoops, I actually didn't want to do 9 to the 2/3. What do you think 9 to the 3/2 is equivalent to? Well, this is the same thing as 9 to the 1/2 power to the 3rd power. And I'll do a whole presentation on exponent, the actual principles of exponents, but it actually turns out you can just multiply. When you have one exponent to another exponent, you could multiply the two, and that's where you get 3/2. But 9 to the 1/2 we know is 3, and raising that to the 3rd power, so that equals 27. I'm sure at this point I have confused you. Let's do more of these. So you know at this point that 16 to the 1/4 power, think about what that is. That means that some number to the 4th power is 16. And if you've been practicing your level 1 exponents, you'll probably know that, well, that equals 2, because 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, well, that equals 16. So we know that 16 to the 1/4 is equal to 2. So what do you think 16 to the 2/4 is equal to? Well, we already know from that last problem that that's the same thing as 16 to the 1/4 squared, that's the 2 in both sides, and we know 16 to the 1/4 is 2, so that equals 2 squared, and that equals 4. And it all works out because we know from fractions, another way to write the fraction 2/4 is to write 1/2, so this is the same thing as 16 to the 1/2 power. And 16 to the 1/2 power, well, that's just equal to 4. Now I'm going to mix it up real good and do some negative fractional exponents. So what if I were to tell you 16 to the negative 1/2 power? Well, this might seem very daunting at first, but as we know with the negative exponents, level 3, immediately we just say, well, this is the same thing as 1 over 16, 1 over 16 to the positive 1 half. And that's the same thing as 1 to the 1 half over 16 to the 1 half. Well, the square root of 1 is easy. It's 1. And 16 to the 1 half is 4. So that wasn't too bad. It's a little daunting when you see a negative exponent, but immediately when you see that negative, just flip the 16 and then work it out like a regular fractional exponent problem. Let's do another one. 8 over 27 to the, let's say, negative 1/3. Immediately when we see that negative, we want to just flip it. So we'll say that equals 27 over 8 to the 1/3. And that equals 27 to the 1/3 over 8 to the 1/3. And we know that 27 to the 1/3, well, that equals 3. And 8 to the 1/3, well, that equals 2. 2. So we've got 3 halves. So we got 8 over 27 to the negative 1/3 is 3 halves. This first problem probably looked very intimidating to you, but it only took us 2 steps to get there. And as you do more practice, hopefully it'll seem more and more intuitive to you. Let me give you another problem. What's negative 8 to the negative 3rd power? No, actually, let me change that. What's negative 8 to the negative 1/3 power? And once again, at first this might confuse you, but when you see that negative in the exponent, we just take the reciprocal of the base so that we say that that is equal to negative 1 over 8, negative 1 over 8 to the 1/3 power. And we say, well, that is equal to, we could write it as 1 over negative 8 to the 1/3. We say, what number times itself 3 times is equal to negative 8? Well, we know from intuition there's no real mechanical way to do this, but we know that negative 2 times negative 2 is 4, times negative 2 is negative 8. So we know that this is equal to 1 over negative 2, or negative 1 half. So negative 8 to the negative 1/3 is equal to minus 1 half. Let's do another one more problem, just to thoroughly melt your brain. Let's say 9 over 4 to the negative 3 over 2. Well, immediately we see that negative exponent. Let's flip the base. We get 4 over 9 to the 3 halves. Well, we know that that equals 4 over 9 to the 1 half, and then all of that to the 3rd power. 4 over 9 to the 1 half, I think at this point you know that's the same thing as 4 to the 1 half, which is 2, over 9 to the 1 half, which is 3, and then we have to just raise everything to the 3rd power. And that's the same thing as 2 to the 3rd power, which is 8. That's an 8. Sometimes a computer acts funny. Divided by 3 to the 3rd power, well, that's 27. There we have 9 fourths to the negative 3 halves power is equal to 8 over 27. Now, hopefully you can at least do these problems, and you probably don't have a good intuitive sense for exactly what a negative 3 halves power is, and hopefully I can cover that for you in future modules. But I think you're ready to try some of the level 3 exponent practice problems. Have fun!